Is the lucky draw a scam, yes or no? Is the Manowar the new best gun in the game? And if so, is Call of Duty Mobile finally pay to win now? We're gonna answer all these questions today and more. We're gonna look at the hot topics on Reddit about the microtransactions in Call of Duty Mobile and putting the new gun skins behind a paywall. So let's get into it. And before we start, make sure you guys enter my Season 3 Battle Pass giveaway. I got 6 Season Pass to give away on the YouTube comments and 2 more on Twitter. All you have to do is subscribe to the channel and look for that video on my YouTube channel. You leave your info in the comments below and then check out my Twitter and retweet that tweet for 2 extra chances to win. All right, let's go, guys. What's up with the lucky draw? Is it a scam? That's the big question. Is this a scam? So before we answer, you gotta define what a scam is, because it's a pretty big word. A scam usually is like a fraud, is when something is dishonest. So let's say that the first lucky draw we had in the game, the Halloween lucky draw, yes, it was a scam because the odds were not correctly displayed. They would say, let's say you have like 40% chance to get an epic drop. But the thing is, it was not all the same odds. Some epics had like 35%, but some epics had 0% and 1%. So what that means is if you keep spinning and spinning, the odds are you'll probably get the skin on your very last spin or the last 2 spins. So there was a huge controversy. All the YouTubers started calling out. It didn't take long. Less than 24 hours after the first lucky draw, everyone realized that after spinning a few spins, the last 2 items were the top 2, the skin and the weapon. And it was pretty much like that for everyone, except a few lucky guys, but it's the odds. There's a 1% chance that you might get lucky. So they reacted, they answered the community, and they now correctly displayed the odds. And now you know, like the gun is like 0.something%, and the skin is like 1%. So yes, you will have to spend about $200 to spin and get all the items until the end. Well, you get probably the last 2 items. So can we really say it is a scam now? Well, since the odds are displayed correctly now, you know what you're getting into. If you decide to spin, well, you know what to expect. You're probably gonna get the green items first. Maybe you get lucky and you'll get a blue, but can you expect the skin or the gun on your first 2, 3, 4 spins? Not really, guys. So because of that, I'm not touching this one. I didn't touch the one before, the Christmas draw. I didn't like the skin that much. I also didn't like the weapon that much, although it was the first legendary weapon in the game. I mean, it was just another AK with a weird Christmas skin that I never really liked. So I'm not spending $200 for a weapon that I don't want. Also, it's just a skin for an AK-117 and everyone has one, right? Now the Spectre character, it looks a bit weird. Once again, some guys say a Power Ranger, a Transformer, or whatever you want to say. It is weird. It's really not my style and I'm not spending. I know I would probably get it just before the end. So maybe $100, $75. But still, it's not worth it for me, so I'm not gonna touch it. I also didn't go all the way on the Halloween stuff. I just spin a few times. I didn't get lucky and I stopped. But the Cosmos lucky draw, I did go. I wanted the skin. I wanted to try the new Razorback. And I did spend $200 to get everything. It's a decision. You know the odds. You decide what you want to do with your money. But is it a scam? Not anymore, in my opinion. It's not a scam if the odds are displayed. Now, the big problem is if they put a weapon there and it's the best weapon in the game. I woke up this morning, I checked the YouTube feed, and I saw iFerg says, oh my god, the Man of War is the best weapon in the game now. And I was like, oh my god. But then I said, wait, it's iFerg, right? Every time there's a new weapon coming out, it's always the best weapon. Oh my god, this is insane. Yeah, it's like his way to title his videos and do his thumbnails. I'm not bashing iFerg. I watch a lot of his stuff. I like the guy. He's very good at the game. But you know, being a YouTuber, you want people to click on your videos. He got a huge audience. But I just remember not that long ago when the DLQ came out for Christmas, he said, oh my god, the DLQ is insane. And then just before that, it was the Locust. And he said, oh my god, the Locust is insane. So to these players, every gun is insane and every gun shreds. Before that, he said the HG40 is the best SMG in COD Mobile. It has no recoil and it's the best. And then he says the M16 is the most underrated secret weapon. So I say, okay, this is Ferg. I gotta check other YouTubers, see what they think about the Manowar. Because just watching this video is not going to be enough info for me. I didn't even click the video, honestly. Then I check Hawk's Nest, and Hawk's Nest usually is going to give you very accurate info with stats. And then I watch Hawkness video. He said, question mark, is it the best AR in his thumbnail? And then he gives you the stats. So it ended up that the Manowar has the lowest mobility in all ARs. It's the slowest movement speed. It's got one of the slowest aim down sight time. It's got the worst recoil in all ARs in the game. So it's actually very bad, but it's got high damage at medium range. So at medium range, it's gonna have the fastest time to kill. So once again, it's gonna come down to your playstyle, but also I'm thinking ranked multiplayer. I'm thinking search and destroy. I'm thinking team deathmatch. The action is fast paced. People rush and they get in your face. And people use MSMC and people use Type 25 more than anything. It's all about fast fire rate, time to kill at close range. So I think this Manowar is not for search and destroy. It's not for team deathmatch, but it could be used in domination. If you're guarding a spot at medium long range, I think that could be a good weapon for certain situations depending on your playstyle. But is it the best AR in the game? Definitely not. So because of that, is Call of Duty Mobile pay to win? I would still say no, guys. The top weapons in the game are free still. And this is my opinion, of course. The only problem and the only argument the people have to say that COD Mobile is pay to win is some guns are not available if you don't spend money. But we will have them soon, I'm pretty sure. Season 3 will give us the Razorback and the Locust as free to play. But even then, if I give you a Razorback tomorrow, are you gonna finally become super good at the game? Are you gonna win in ranked multiplayer? The answer is no. Razorback totally sucks. It's a PDW. It is not a top 5 weapon in ranked multiplayer. Same thing for Locust. People still use the DLQ. People still use Arctic 50. Some guys use the Locust, but it's personal preference. It doesn't make the game pay to win. And same thing for the Manowar. If everyone has Manowar tomorrow, you think the Call of Duty meta will suddenly become everyone using Manowar? The answer is, again, is no. It's not the top weapon in the game, in my opinion, of course. So to answer the first three questions, the Lucky Draw is not a scam. It is overpriced, totally overpriced, but it's not a scam. It's not the same. Then Manowar is not the top weapon in the game. It's not the top AR in the game. And it's not even a top 5 weapon in the game, in my opinion. And then the game is not pay to win still. You can be the best player in the game and spend $0 in the game. So we can now start talking about the Reddit bashing, I guess. I do read the Reddit every day. I check the hot topics. I see what people are talking about. And I see a lot of posts about YouTubers. Oh my God, another lucky draw. All the YouTubers gonna spend money in the game. And because of these YouTubers, this will never stop. Well, guys, this is totally wrong. Just like 3-4 YouTubers spend a couple $100. You think it will make a difference if these 3-4 YouTubers stop? There's tons of players using these lucky draws. There's tons of players with money, and they have to pay for the millions of players that don't put a dollar in the game. Usually when they release a Call of Duty game, millions of players will buy it. It's like $50, $60. And then they'll release 5 DLCs throughout the year for $10, $15 the DLC. And a lot of players will buy all the DLCs. So it's $100 for every game they sold. Now they release a free game, 10 million people downloaded on the first day. And out of these 10 million people, I'm pretty sure 9 million or 7 million will never put a dollar. So the other players that play the game have to pay for the game, but also for everyone else that doesn't pay, right? Kind of. They have to make their money. If this is working for them, I mean, if you don't like it, just don't buy. It doesn't make a difference. It does not give you an advantage in the game at all. It's just a bunch of skins. And like I said, the top weapons out there, MSMC, Type 25, DLQ, or Arctic, you can get to legendary rank in ranked multiplayer with MSMC and Type 25 only if you want. You just need to play more and get better. It's not the weapon, it's the player most of the time. And then last thing is, as far as I know, I checked the Reddit, and the YouTubers, they don't post their videos on Reddit, guys. They don't spam their videos. So if you don't like, just don't watch. Why create posts to laugh and bash YouTubers? they're not even posting their stuff on Reddit, so you're watching their videos. Like, just stop watching. If you don't like what they do, just don't watch. I mean, live and let live, right? If they enjoy what they do, if they like doing videos, and honestly, I do enjoy Hawksness content, and I'm pretty happy he did the video on the Manowar today. I watched it, and it really was informative, and now I have another reason not to buy it, because now I know it's not the top weapon in the game. So I'll say it. Thank you, Hawkness, and yes, it does help, and keep doing what you do. I really enjoy your content, and I hope you keep going. So that's gonna be it for me, and I will do it. I will spin it once. 80 COD points? I'm ready to gamble 80 COD points. I know I will probably get trash, but there's a small chance I might get something cool. Maybe the emote, maybe a glacier skin, whatever. So let's do it once, but then that's it, all right? Let's go. Boom! We got the S36 reindeer. So I was expecting something like that, something green. I didn't have it, by the way, but then I'm gonna stop. I don't wanna spend 120 COD points for maybe the M4 or the Cheekam or whatever. And I know the odds of getting something cool are very, very, very slim. So I'm just gonna stop it right there. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Once again, leave a comment below. I will read everything. I wanna know what you guys think. That was just my opinion. Once again, Eifert, not bashing at all. I'm just pointing out that it's entertainment and yeah, title clickbaity a little bit. Get people excited wanting to watch the videos, and I totally understand that. So that's it for me. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. I will be back later. Until then, watch my other stuff. Take care.